We are going to have lunch in a few minutes. We got the check from Renault this morning, so we're springing for lunch.
Well, in 1998, we were in pretty bad shape. I mean, we were very close to bankruptcy and a company that really didn't have direction. I mean, I think that was the biggest problem of all and financial things you can deal with, but directionless company. And at that time, we knew we needed to do something that would dramatically alter the way the company performed. And we formed an alliance with Renault. And Mr. Carlos Ghosn, who had been working with Renault at that time in Europe, became our president and chief operating officer. And he brought a real different to the way the company operates and the way it views things. And the success that has come from that has been incredible.
You know, one other thing which is very specific about Nissan is we have three-year plans, we have specific objectives with time frame. You can measure them and you can decide if we're successful or not.
I think when Carlos Ghosn went to Nissan, everybody thought he would fall on his face and Nissan would go bankrupt. And everybody was saying that Daimler Chrysler were going to be the next entity, maybe the future number one. And 5 years later, I mean, Nissan is really doing very well. And Daimler Chrysler, they are debating in court if it was a good deal or not. But at Nissan, they stayed Nissan. And maybe the decision makers were from Paris, but at least they respected the culture of Nissan.
They were once, I think, $22 billion in debt. They had virtually no profit. Now they've erased, I think, in 5 years, all of the debt. They're the most profitable company in terms of operating margin by far, by 2%, which is a huge, incredible margin in the entire automotive business. And it's all because of his leadership. It really is.
For the longer term, what's very important and the main challenge for me is to make sure that the company continues to move with the same drive, with the same passion, with the same energy, without ever falling into complacency or comfort, or let's take a break here, let's enjoy a little bit, let's consolidate here. No, the commitment was that the first year of the plan, bring back the company to profitability, that even though we were investing massively in the future of the company, the debt would be reduced by half on the first 3 years and then eliminated, and that the company would go back to growth. Every single objective had a milestone, and so far, every single objective has been overachieved at or before the milestone which was planned.
Carlos Ghosn and Bob Lutz are the kind of people that if I was in the infantry, I'd follow up Hamburger Hill. And when you can motivate people for that kind of way, they give you your best effort. And that's what being Carlos Ghosn has done for Nissan. That people have been inspired by him, the people that work for him have been inspired by him, and they're willing to do whatever it takes to make the product necessary for Nissan to be successful.